si bon de partir n'importe où.
Hey guys, it's Erica, and today I'm coming to you with a little bit different kind of a video. I have made it pretty well known that I am going to be going to Paris in October. And I think I mentioned it in one of my other videos. I love getting inspiration for my outfits from people I've seen on TV or movies or something like that, okay? And so when I think of Paris, I always think of Carrie Bradshaw from Sex and the City. This was on the last season of Sex and the City. And the episodes were called An American Girl in Paris Part 1 and American Girl in Paris Part 2. And when she arrives in Paris, she has this beautiful like black and white striped shirt with this big rosette on the chest and the really pretty black and white striped skirt. And I absolutely love that outfit. When I think of Parisian fashion, like black and white stripes are the first thing that I think of. I knew I wanted an outfit like this. And so I started going online and trying to research what it was she was wearing just to get an idea of where I might be able to find something like that. And you have to keep in mind, that show was filmed either 12 or 14 years ago, so it's been a while. But I was able to find in an article, they interviewed the stylist from the show, and they said that her top alone was sold at Saks Fifth Avenue. It was from a French designer. And I looked all over for something similar. I searched everything I could online. You know, rosette sweater, black and white striped rosette shirt, everything in the world that you can think of, I searched for it, and I didn't find anything that resembled that outfit that Carrie was wearing. So I went ahead and decided to go ahead and make my own version of that outfit. And it really wasn't that hard. It really wasn't. So today I wanted to sit down and just kind of show you what I did. I did a more in-depth blog post that I will link down below. And then there's also a YouTube video that I'm going to link down in the description bar as well. And that's the one that I used to see how to sew the waistband of my skirt. But we'll get into all that here in just a few minutes. Things you're going to need. You're going to need two identical black and white striped shirts. I found mine online from J. Crew. They were on sale and they were $21.50 each. My skirt I actually found from Forever 21 in the clearance section and it was $12. Carrie's outfit, her skirt has a really thick, wide black waistband, and the skirt that I found didn't have that. So I went to Joann's Fabric online and just ordered a 3-inch elastic, and it was like 2 yards of fabric, and I got that for $3, $2.95 I think. And those are the basic items that I used to make the outfit. Since your skirt and your shirt are both black and white striped, you really want a lot of variation in the kinds of stripes on each one. That way they stand apart from each other. You know what I mean? Your shirt, you want to have really skinny, really tight black and white stripes, and you want them to be horizontal. Your skirt, you're going to want your stripes to be much larger and wider apart, and you're going to want a vertical stripe so that way there's a contrast between the two. Just to go ahead and kind of get it out of the way, because it was so simple to do, I'm going to go ahead and tell you how we made the skirt. My skirt, like I said, came from Forever 21, and even though it is vertical stripes, the waistband had a white horizontal stripe around it, and when you put it on, it really did show up, and it looked different than Carrie's. I knew I needed to have a thick black elastic waistband to hide that, so this is actually sewn on top of it. You can see that white stripe here, right? The black waistband that I got was just a piece of fabric that was straight like this, right? I just kind of held it up to my waist and held it to where it met, and then you take a couple inches away from that because you want your elastic to be tight kind of on your waist and not be baggy and hang off loose. You know what I mean? So measure it to where it fits around your waist, and then just take a couple inches off and cut it. And then I went ahead and like sewed the waistband together. That way it was like a circle, okay? When you are working with an elastic fabric like this and a garment, when you go to lay this on it, they don't match up exactly because this has to stretch, okay? Well, my sewing skills are very elementary. Like, I have no sewing skills whatsoever. So I used a YouTube video. I'm going to link that down below. Make sure you check that out because this lady did an excellent job on how to sew an exposed elastic waistband onto a skirt. And for this step, you are going to have to use a sewing machine because the stitching that you do is a zigzag stitch, okay? Picture just a basic spool of thread. You know, that it doesn't give. There's no elastic in it. So if you take a garment that is supposed to stretch up on you, okay? An elastic waistband. And you just sewed like a solid straight line stitch across the fabric, there would be no give to it. So whenever you tried to put on your skirt and slide it up and you tried to like stretch it out, you would kind of snap that thread. You know what I mean? A zigzag stitch allows a stretchy fabric to still be stretchy. Okay. But basically you take both your elastic waistband and your skirt and you're going to pin each one 4 times. You're going to pin it like in the front where your belly button would be, the front center. You're going to do the back center, like where your tag would be in the back of your skirt. And then you do one on either side. Okay? So it's the north, the south, the east, and the west. Okay. And you do that for both of them. Then, once you have them both pinned, you pin them together. So you'll put the front pins together, the back pins together, and then each side pin together. This is a little hard to explain, and you'll understand it better when you watch that other lady's video. So when you sit down at the sewing machine, you have to hold both of them together, like in your hand, where one pin is, okay? So you hold the waistband and the skirt together, and then hold where the next set of pins are. And then you pull both of them together. And when you pull them out like that, they lay flat together. And then you kind of just zip it through your sewing machine from pin to pin. Then once you get to the next section, you hold it together with your left hand. Hold it together at the next set of pins with your right hand. And you zip it through your sewing machine. I know that probably sounds confusing, but just watch that video and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. Sewing this waistband on the skirt took all of maybe 2 minutes, 90 seconds, something like that. And that's literally all I did to my skirt. In that YouTube video, that woman sews on a waistband without any seams. Like she does a fancier version is what I'm saying. But where I had to hide this white waistband, I just laid this on top and stitched it around. That's all there is to the skirt. And now to the shirt. Definitely the most tedious part of this is making the rosette. But believe it or not, I actually did this in one evening. It took me probably about 2 hours to make the rosette. So like I said in the beginning, you have 2 shirts that are identical. Put one shirt to the side because that's actually going to be the shirt that you're going to wear, okay? Use that other one to make your rosette. And you need like a big piece of fabric to work with. So the first thing that I did was I cut the shirt even at the armpit area. I'll show you. I cut it straight across. That way I would have a big piece of fabric to work with. I then cut up the side of that piece of fabric and that gave me one big rectangle of fabric to work with. I divided that into 3 sections and made 3 long strips. And then I just went ahead and ironed each strip just to make sure they were wrinkle-free and I pressed the seams so that they laid flat and that kind of thing. Then I took each one of those strips and I folded it in half. And then after I kind of pressed and creased each piece of fabric, and then I just took fabric glue and I put it in kind of the center part and then just folded it over and pressed it together. So after I had folded each one over and glued it, I sewed all 3 of those strips together to give me 1 long continuous strip. Because after I looked at Carrie's rosette on her shirt, I could tell it was one piece of fabric and they had looped it back and forth to make the rosette. So you have to have 1 really long strip to make your rosette. What you're left with after that is like a long kind of rectangle piece of fabric. So when you start trying to assemble your rosette, like you can't lay this out in a circle. See what I'm saying? Like it folds up kind of funny. And you have to lay your fabric out in a circle to make the rosette. So in order to get your strip of fabric to work, you have to kind of curl your fabric or make it ribbon-like. That way it wants to lay in a circle. Okay. And so the way that I did that is I just did a basic running stitch at the base of my strip of fabric. And after I did the running stitch, I just kind of lightly pulled back on the fabric in on itself and kind of scrunched it a little. And what that does is kind of gives your fabric a ribbon-like effect and it makes it curl. And after your fabric is kind of curled like that, it lays perfectly in a circle. And so after I finished doing that to the whole strip of fabric, and honest to God, that only took maybe 5 or 10 minutes. Like that goes very, very fast. I just took my other shirt, my whole shirt, and laid it down. I just took a few minutes and studied Carrie's shirt like I had a picture of it on my phone. And I would sit and study it and try to figure out how in the world they made that rosette. And it took several different angles. Like I watched the show on TV and I would just sit and watch and look and I took screenshots of it. And I still don't have it down exactly, but I know pretty good how they did it. like at first glance, I thought they just took the fabric and like wrapped it around and around and around and made a big rose. That's not what they did. It actually zigzags back and forth. So they actually like kind of wrapped it around and then they would get to one side and loop it back and take it up and loop it back and take it up and loop it back, if that makes sense. I started in the center of the shirt making my rosette, and I first did a loop around, like a 360 degree loop around, and I ended up on the underside of the rosette. I looped my fabric back, took it around all the way to the top of the rosette, looped it back around, took it all the way to the bottom of the rosette, and looped it back around, and that's where it finished. And you know, mine is not exactly like Carrie's, but I was just really happy with how the rosette looked whenever I just kind of loosely laid it out on my shirt. And so then I just went ahead and carefully pinned each layer of my petals down onto the shirt. The next thing that you have to do is just very delicately put your shirt on. Where it's a stretchier fabric, the rosette is going to look different once it's on your body, especially if you have a large chest. Everything gets kind of pushed out and stretched out, and it looks a little different once it's pinned on. While it was on my body, I looked in the mirror and I just kind of adjusted and moved my pins around and got it to where I thought it looked pretty while it was on my body. Then I just carefully took the shirt back off, careful not to get stuck with a pin. And so then you just sew your rosette on. And that is actually a lot simpler than you would think. I just kind of slid one hand up in the shirt and would start and do the base of each layer and sewed it on layer by layer. And again, I just did like a basic running stitch. I did stop ever so often and kind of knot my thread to reinforce everything just because I wanted it to be, you know, really sturdy. To sew the whole thing on, it only took maybe about 15 to 30 minutes, something like that. And that night, I actually went out to dinner with my family and I wore the shirt because I wanted to like see how it looked. I wanted to show my mom and my aunts, really. I wanted to like see how it photographed. I wanted to see how it looked from different angles, how well it wore, if it felt sturdy, if I needed to make any changes. And when I sewed it originally, I only sewed at the base of each layer and I left all this really loose and floppy. So my layers would kind of flop apart. And if you watch the show, like Carrie's shirt is really floppy, but hers doesn't really fall apart and show the seams. So I don't know exactly how they sewed hers on, but I had originally left mine floppy to be like hers. The next morning when I got up, I kind of tacked my layers together. That way they don't flop open. Because I really just wanted the shirt to be pretty from every angle. And once I had all of my layers or petals or whatever kind of tacked flat, that way nothing really moves, I really do like it better. And I also decided to add a little bit of fabric here in the center of the rosette because I just wasn't really happy with how it looked that first night in photos. So I went back in with my first shirt and I took the end of one of the sleeves. Hopefully you can see I cut this one off. And again, I just went around the base of it doing a running stitch and then pulling it and scrunching the fabric back so that it would be in a rosette fashion. And then I just stitched the base of it right into the center of the shirt. And guys, that's it. That's basically the whole outfit. And you know, I know it sounds like a lot kind of right off the bat. I promise you, it really isn't. And you do not have to be like the best sewer in the world. Like, I'm not a seamstress. I don't even own a sewing machine. I had to go to my mom's house and use her sewing machine. So if I can do this, I promise you, literally anybody can do this. As with most things that you create, I think that lack of skill, you totally make up for that with inspiration and desire, right? And like, nothing about my outfit is perfect, but guess what? There's not an inch of Erica Jones than he is, so that's perfect for me. I don't even know if there's another single soul out there that would be interested in this outfit because it's a little flashy. You know, it's a little different than typical things that you see. But if you are a Sex and the City fan, if you're a Carrie Bradshaw fan or a Sarah Jessica Parker fan, then, you know, this totally might be something that you would want to do too. And if so, I hope that this gave you enough of an idea of how you could create it, okay? Again, check out my blog. I'll link it down below. Watch that other video to see exactly what I was talking about sewing that waistband on. And guys, I really don't think you'll have a problem. If there's something that I didn't explain good enough, leave me a comment down below, ask me any questions, and I'll be sure to answer it, okay? But you know, even if it's not this, if there's something out there that you're just really wanting and they don't make it anymore, or you can't afford it, or whatever the case may be, I highly recommend really putting your mind to work and coming up with a way that you could possibly create it yourself. There's something so rewarding about making something with your own two hands. And it being like an original. Like no one else has this. I don't even know if anybody else would want it. But like I said, honey, it's perfect for me. And I can just see myself at some little sidewalk cafe in Paris, sitting next to someone who paid $5,000 for their outfit. And me in my little, what, $60 outfit. And being totally content and happy. So, guys, thank you so much for watching this today. I encourage you to be creative and make things that you love. Have a great weekend, what's left of the weekend, and I'll see you next week.